Hey everybody, today I'm going to talk about neural filters in Photoshop. That's chapter 15 in the 2024 release of the Photoshop Classroom in a Book. But Adobe has just released the 2025 version of Photoshop, and it may look a little different than what we see in the book or what we expect from the exercise. So we're just going to go through it together and we'll be surprised together. Let's do it. Now I'm going to open Photoshop. I've already got Photoshop 2025 here. I'm going to go ahead and make it full screen. So this is the start screen. It looks pretty normal. If you have just started up Photoshop 2025 for the first time, you might get some what's new news and things to look at. I can come up here and choose help and what's new, and Photoshop will take me through these several new tutorials for the new Photoshop 2025 and some of the neat new capabilities the application has. I'll let you explore those on your own. But now I wanted to go through the chapter 15 of the 2024 release of the Photoshop Classroom in a Book and talk about neural filters. All right, first I'll open the file that I want to work on. I'll choose File, Open, 15 Restore. Okay, so here we have this image that Photoshop is asking us to restore. I'll drag the contextual taskbar out of the way. I'll press Command 0 to make that a little bigger. We can see this picture is torn, has some imperfections in it. Maybe it's a little dark. So we'll use the neural filters to fix it. To get started working on this picture, we'll choose Filter and Neural Filters. And here, it opens the neural filters menu, and what this does is it uses this machine intelligence to find a face. If there were multiple faces, we would have the option over here on the right-hand side to choose other faces. But in this case, we want to try photo restoration. And you see how this says beta here? That means that they're still working on this, and through Creative Cloud, Photoshop will be updated as these different tools come out of development. I'll just click on. It's processing on my device here. And wow, that's okay. And you can see what's happened. We can look at the preview, show original here. There's the original. There's the restored version. We can move some of these photo restoration sliders around to change different aspects or to strengthen different effects of the filter. So I just jacked up photo enhancement to 100 and enhance face to 100. How about enhance face to 0? Nope. Right. So you can see what it's doing here. It almost looks like a drawing now that it's on 100 enhance face. So I'll just dial it back some. Scratch reduction. You can try this one to see what it'll do to scratch up here. Tear. It might take a while depending on the size of your photo. Wow. Pretty great. So that's not a bad restoration job there. So maybe we don't want to make it look so doctored, but more like midway, right? We don't want to overdo it. I think that looks really nice. So we can come back here and go back to the original and then to this restored version. Doing this by hand, it takes a lot more work. I suggest that you might start with neural filters, but you would really want to come back and give an overview to this image by hand to make sure that it reflects the quality of the image that you want to deliver. I'll output this to a smart filter and choose OK. And what happens now is that this layer, our adjustment is on this smart filter, which is a neural filter. Because we've made it a smart filter, we can go back and change the settings anytime we want. It preserves our ability to edit non-destructively. So that's the neural filter around restoring. Now I'll open another image called Colorize. The neural filter will look at an image and decide what colors it should be: skin color, clothes, background. So here we have this kid. I'll choose Filter and Neural Filters and then Colorize. And the filter does what it thinks is best. You can also change some of these color filter options. You can change these to different profiles that will affect how the how the image is colored. With the automatic coloring, we can come in here and change the saturation of the colors, our color balance, maybe shift it more towards the red. Noise reduction does a kind of remove some of the dots maybe from the image. Color artifacts, same thing. And if we want to change a color of the image, say the kid's sweater, right? It's blue and something. You could just click on that part of the image and select a different color. And then that becomes red, that area. Of course, now we have to go and spread that around. I can hold the Option key down to spread that color to different parts of the sweater to make sure that the calculation extends there, right? So now we've kind of put it all over the sweater, reddish. So you see the result. We can change it a little bit manually. We can use the colorize neural filter, make these kinds of adjustments overall, universal adjustments, and change individual parts of the image. And then when we have this image colored the way we like it, again, choose output smart filter and okay. And now we have that colorized image. I'm really fascinated with this new colorizing ability because it's so easy, at least giving you a starting point. And so I use it in combination with other Photoshop techniques to restore old photos. Here's another restored image. This is an old family picture, and you can see how damaged it is. You could use some improvements, right? This is from about 1938. And here's the after, where I've used the neural filters and the colorization in combination with other tools to restore this image, such as I'm going to hit Command plus 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 here. And I've just now noticed this little squiggle right there. And so I'll use my spot healing brush tool and come over here and just kind of dab over that to fix it. And there. Beautiful. So just, I don't have the layers still on this document to show you all of the steps that I went through, but this is sort of how a restoration process would incorporate both manual fixes, other Photoshop fixes, and then also incorporating the colorize filter to help you get results like this. And now we'll talk about compositing images, putting them together and making them convincing to your audience. So I'll go ahead and open up 15composite.psd, and we can see it's a big background, 2000 pixels by 1030 pixels at 300 pixels per inch. We're looking at a 66.67% sized image of it down here on the bottom left, this information. And right here we see we have a new layer called Heroine, where she is masked out of a different background. So we'll apply that mask, we'll turn that mask back on. What I'm doing here is pressing Control and then clicking on the mask and choosing Disable Layer Mask to turn it off to see what's behind it. And you can see the big X means it's turned off. I'll Control click again and choose Enable Layer Mask. And our goal here is to make this more convincing, right? Right now it looks like this person was pasted on to something else. First, I'll make sure that the planet layer is selected, and then I'll come up here and choose Filter, Neural Filters. You'll see it up here as Neural Filters, and what this would do is reapply the last filter, but it doesn't work with the Neural Filters, and you wouldn't want to do that anyway. So I'll choose Neural Filters, and because I have the background layer selected, you can see that no faces were detected for this image. What I want to do here is choose the Landscape Mixer. And you can see that it has this cloud here, and I have to download it before I can use it. So I'll just click on it, it downloads, and here we are. Now you can see that this layer is selected with the blue line here, and I want to change the look of the landscape, the light effects, things like that. And so I'll click on this one here to make it redder, processing on device. And we could see how that affected the background image, the layer that we have this cutout person on. So you can experiment with these and see what happens, right? We've changed it entirely. Now it's a jungly area or a beach, desert, icy. experiment, encourage you to play. It can be fun and you can see what sort of options you get.
Nice.
We want this canyon looking one here to make this red background. You can also change the strength of the filter. Maybe it's more filtered than you want it to look. You can change the time of day, night, sunset, change the seasons, spring, summer, autumn, winter,
etc.
Now that we've got this background the way we want it, I'm going to change the output to smart filter and choose OK. And now again, we could go back and change that filter any way we like. Now we want to change the lighting effect on the heroin layer here, which I'll click on, to match the background that we've made for it. In order to do that, I will again choose filter, neural filters, and choose harmonization. This is another beta filter. Turn it on. And for reference image, so what this does is it will match, it will harmonize the colors from one image to another or one layer to another. So I'll choose the planet layer, which is the one that I want to harmonize her with. And it's done that. It's tweaked the colors a little bit, but this still doesn't look exactly right. I'm going to move this cyan red slider to get a little more red in there. Much better. Maybe more saturated and less bright. We want a little less brightness because, you know, the sun in this image is shining in the front. So her back, she would be in silhouette to us because the light's on the other side of her. You have to pay attention to where the light is coming from, what direction the light is coming from in your compositions if you want to make them realistic. So we've done all of these things. Let's see what the original looks like. That's the original, and this is what we've done with it. That looks good to me. I'll choose smart filter and okay. And now we have our heroine and background. I've clicked the eyeballs and turned the background off and then turned the filters off on either one. Now I'll click the eye icon on this layer called Guardian. That's our type layer. And so now this composition is complete. It's realistic in the way that I wanted it to appear. I want to talk to you about this Guardian text a little bit. Let me turn my text tool on and select this. So we can see over here in the properties panel that it's alternate Gothic, 108.57 pixels high, or points rather. The color is this bright red color. But when we get down onto the text layer, I see the fill, you know, that bright red color is 60%. And the blending mode used is an overlay, which gives it that kind of sharp popping out texture. What these blending modes do is they determine how one layer interacts with another. And so if we were to change this to something like normal and then bump up the fill, right, it just looks like a flat text. But we can turn it down and experiment with our blending modes to see if there's one that we like better. Yeah, and frankly, overlay is one that I use a lot, vivid light, but we'll leave this one overlay for now. There you go. I finished this exercise. What I'm going to do is choose file, save as tutorial, and my last name. Format will be Photoshop PDF. Please send me a Photoshop PDF. That way it will definitely upload to Blackboard and anybody can see it. I'll click save and then okay. I do not have to preserve Photoshop editing capabilities, and you can bump up the compatibility to Acrobat 8. This will save us some file space and use some file space on your computer's hard drive. I did that one and I'll come here and get this colorized one. You know, if you want to experiment with your own colorizing image, feel free to do that. For example, here's this old news photo of a protest at Clayton State University in 1970. You can see here by the photographer Tom Coffin. And let's say we wanted to colorize this one. Now I'll choose filter and neural filters and then colorize. There we go. That looks pretty nice. Let's say this lady's dress here is not blue, but maybe red. And so I've clicked on that and I'll go ahead and choose this red color here. Say, okay. And then we can see what's happened. It's sort of bleeding over into the shadow and all. You know, I think we could do a better job of that. But you see if we needed to change the colors of anything in here. And just clicking that button doesn't finish the restoration of this image. For example, I might need to come into this smart filters mask and turn on this brush and then black for the masking color and mask out a little bit of this red that's bleeding over. In this case, you know, unfortunately, it's black and white. If I take the filter off, that's a way that we can continue to adjust the image in the way that we would like. And yeah, I really want y'all to feel free to, I really want you to have some fun with this. I'm sure that you have some kind of black and white pictures around your house. Try to colorize them and see what you get and have some fun with it. I've been digging through my archives and colorizing things, and the family loves it. So try it out. Regardless, okay, I got on a little diversion there. Here's the other part of this exercise. I'll choose File, Save As, and then again, Format, Photoshop PDF, Tutorial to Parker. And okay, the settings that I made last time are still in here. Preserve Photoshop doesn't have to be there. Save PDF. And I'll save this one as well. File, Save As, Photoshop PDF, and Tutorial, and my last name. Save. And uncheck, Save PDF. So not a lot seems to have changed between Photoshop 2024 and 2025, at least as far as neural filters are concerned. If you would like to colorize or restore any of your own pictures, please feel free to do that. I would love to see them. Be sure to show me the before so that I can see the before and after images so that I can see what it looked like before you worked on it, and then, you know, what it looks like when you're satisfied with your restoration or colorization. Thanks for listening. If you have any questions, please let me know, and I'll see you soon.